எஸ் ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் மை 8th வீடியோ ஆன் கேல்குலஸ் இந்த பிளே லிஸ்ட் ஆஃப் யூபிஎஸ்சி மேக்ஸ் ஆப்ஷனல். ஸோ 8th வீடியோ இன் சென்ஸ் தட் வி ஆர் சால்விங் த ப்ரீவியஸ் கொஸ்டின் பேப்பர்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் 1992 டு 2019 அண்ட் ஓவரால் திஸ் இஸ் 33rd வீடியோ ஆன் கேல்குலஸ் ரைட். ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் 25 வீடியோஸ் வில் கிவ் யூ எ பேஸ் அண்ட் ஆஃப்டர் தட் ஐ எம் சால்விங் த ப்ரீவியஸ் இயர்ஸ் கொஸ்டின் பேப்பர்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் 1992 டு 2019. ஸோ வி ஆர் ஃபினிஷ்ட் 1992 ரைட். ஸோ தேர் ஆர் 5 ப்ராப்ளம்ஸ் தட் ஆஸ்க் இன் கேல்குலஸ் ஃப்ரம் 1992. So we have finished all 5. So this is from part 1 to part 5. And from part 6 and part 7, we have solved 2 problems from 1993. So still there are 2 problems left in 1993. After that, we will move on to 1994. And the important information is that after finishing 5 question papers, that is 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, what you will do is you will classify the problems based on the structure. So whether the problem is asked in, whether the problem is from continuous or it is from differentiability or whether it is from double integrals or whether it is from triple integral. So we will classify each problems into separate area so that you will have a clear idea that which part is very important from UPSC point of view. So still there are 2 problems left in 993 and then we will move on to 1994, right. So 993, third problem is show that the volume common to the sphere and the cylinder is x square plus y square is equal to 2ax. So that the volume common to the sphere x square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square and the cylinder x square plus y square is equal to 2ax is 2a square by 9 into 3 pi minus 4. So we will solve this. So you should always be very careful that whenever you have a problem that is based on volume between sphere and cylinder, you should always change the coordinates from Cartesian coordinates to a cylindrical coordinates, right. So very important point. So whenever you have a problem from volume between sphere and the cylinder, you should always transform the Cartesian coordinates to cylindrical coordinates. So I'll tell you how to transform the Cartesian coordinates to cylindrical coordinates, right. Yes. So this comes under, so what we'll do is we will transform Cartesian to cylindrical. That is x comma y comma z is been transformed to rho comma phi comma z right. Or it can also be theta, right. It can also be theta. So I'll write theta, rho comma theta comma z, right. So using the transformation, x should be transformed to r cos rho cos theta, right. X should be transformed to rho cos theta and y should be transformed to rho sin theta and z should be remain z as it is, right. So x comma y comma z is been transformed to rho comma theta comma z. So rho comma theta comma z. So x is rho cos theta, right. So we should transform this. And the triple integral over dx, dy, dz is being transformed to triple integral over rho dz d rho into d theta, right. And this theta varies from 0 to pi. We should find dz and d rho from the question, right. So we will move on to the problem now. So it is given that volume of the sphere is x square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square, right. So we will move on to the problem quickly. So the equation of sphere is given as x square plus y square plus z square is equal to a square, right. So I'm just replacing x to be arrow cos theta, because what I'm doing is I've been transforming Cartesian to cylindrical coordinates. This will be, I'm changing x, y, z to be like this. So this will be rho square cos square theta plus rho square sine square theta plus z square is equal to a square. So from these two terms I can take rho square common. So we have cos square theta plus sine square theta, which is 1. So we have only rho square from these two terms plus z square is equal to a square. So I can also write z square is equal to square root a square minus rho square. So this will be z is equal to plus or minus square root of a square minus rho square. So we have found the bound for z. Now the equation of cylinder is the equation of cylinder. So the equation of cylinder is given as x square plus, sorry, it is ax, right? It is not 2ax, it is ax. So x square plus y square is equal to ax. So if I replace x is equal to again rho square cos square theta, this will become rho square sine square theta is equal to a into rho cos theta, right? I'm just replacing x and y. So again I can take rho square common here. So this will be cos square theta plus sine square theta, which is 1. So rho into cos theta. This one rho and this one rho will get cancelled. So we have rho is equal to a cos theta, right? So what we are doing is, so our triple integral, so we have to calculate the volume is, so hence the required volume. The required volume is, so we can calculate triple integral rho into dz d rho into d theta, right? So our theta varies from 0 to pi, we know it is from 0 to pi, and our d rho, it is that 0 to a cos theta. And what we have been doing is, so we need to find the volume common to the sphere and the cylinder. So this is 3 dimension, right? So we will have 2 parts. So what I am doing is, I am only finding this part and I am multiplying 2 to the answer. So what I am going to do is, I can multiply 2 here and I can restrict z to 0 to square root of a square minus x square, right? So this, that's it. So we should find the triple integral value to prove our result. So in the first, you can see in this integral rho is independent of z. So this integral will remain in 0 to pi, and this will be 0 to a cos theta. And I can take rho outside. Integral dz is z. The limit is from 0 to square root of a square minus x square into d theta, into d rho into d theta. So I can write this integral to be 2 times integral 0 to pi and integral 0 to a cos theta rho into square root of a square minus, sorry, this rho square, right? A square minus rho square into d rho into d theta. Now we should find the integral of this part, right? We should integrate rho into square root of a square minus rho square d rho. So first I'll so you mark this equation as 1. So what you will do is, first integrate this part and then you'll substitute in 1. So what I'm doing is, so I'm just going to integrate rho into square root of a square minus rho square into d rho, right? So first integrate this and then substitute here. So I'm going to make a substitution, put t is equal to a square minus rho square. So this will, dt by d rho will be 0 minus 2 rho. So I can write dt is equal to minus 2 rho into d rho. So I can write rho into d rho to be minus dt by 2, right? So you can see this will be changed to, so I can write rho into d rho. Rho into d rho as minus dt by 2. This is nothing but root t into minus dt by 2, right? So this is t, so root t into minus dt by 2. So we will have minus 1 by 2 will be taken outside. So we will have integral t power 1 by 2 dt. This will be minus 1 by 2 t power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. So if I bring 3 by 2 to that side, we will have minus 1 by 3 t power 3 by 2. So again I replace t to be a square minus x square. So our integral will be a square minus x square whole power 3 by 2. So this is our integral rho into a square minus rho square d rho will be minus 1 by 3 a square minus rho square, right? I don't know why I'm writing x square. So it will be a square minus rho square whole power minus 3 by 2. Now we can, our volume will be 2 times integral 0 to pi, and we know integral rho into a square minus rho square d rho will be minus 1 by 3 a square minus rho square whole power 3 by 2. Remember, we need to apply the limit. The limit is from 0 to a cos theta into d theta, right? So I'm just d theta, this argument as it is, so I'm just replacing integral to be this value. Now we will apply upper limit and the lower limit. So we will have 2 times integral 0 to pi. So if I apply upper limit, I'll have minus 1 by 3 a square minus rho square. So rho square will be a square cos square theta, right? A square cos square theta. So it will be a square cos square theta minus lower limit. So lower limit will be minus 1 by 3 a square minus 0 whole power 3 by 2 into d theta. So this will be 2 times integral 0 to pi. So minus 1 by 3, if I take a square common, it will be 1 minus cos square theta, right? So I can write 1 minus cos square theta as, it is 3 by 2 there. So I can write a, if I take a square, so I cannot take a square common, right? So let it be a square, if I take common here, I'll have 1 minus cos square theta whole power 3 by 2. So it'll be plus 1 by 3 a square 3 by 2 will be a cube. So I'll be a cube by 3 into d theta. So this will be 2 times integral 0 to pi. So this will be minus 1 by 3. If I bring power to each term, a square whole power 3 by 2 is a cube. And this will be sin square theta, and sin square theta whole power 3 by 2. So sin square theta whole power 3 by 2, this 2 will get cancelled. So we have sin cube theta plus a cube by 3 into d theta. So if I take a cube by 3 outside or common, so we will have 2 is here. So I'm just checking a cube by 3 outside. So we will have integral 0 to pi. So here we will have only minus sin cube theta. This will be 1. So we will have 1 minus sin cube theta into d theta. Right? So we will have integral 0 to pi 1 minus sin cube theta d theta. So this will be 2a cube by 3. I can write this as integral d theta from 0 to pi. And this will be integral sin cube theta d theta from 0 to pi. Now this will be 2a cube by 3, and this will be integral d theta is nothing but theta. So if you apply upper limit and lower limit, we will have pi. So you can do this integral, right? So this will be, you can use sin cube theta formula. So our sin cube theta formula will be 3 sin theta minus sin 3 theta by 4, right? So you can do it in your own, or else I'll just give the int. Yes. So we know that sine 3 theta is equal to, you know, sine 3 theta is equal to 3 sine theta minus 4 sine cube theta. 4 sine cube theta. So if I bring that side, we will have 4 sine cube theta is equal to 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta. Yes. So sine cube theta, I can write this as 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta by 4. So I can replace sine cube theta to be this value. So I can take 1 by 4 outside. 1 by 4 outside. So this will be integral 0 to pi 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta into d theta, right? So again, these are very elementary. As you can do this, it will be pi minus 1 by 4. This will be 3 by 4 integral sine theta d theta. It is from 0 to pi. I'm just splitting this integral to 1 by 4. So it will be plus 1 by 4 integral sine 3 theta d theta from 0 to pi. So we will have 2 a cube by 3. So it will be pi minus 3 by 4. Integral sine theta is minus cos theta. So this is from 0 to pi. This is from 1 by 4 to integral sine 3 theta is minus cos 3 theta by 3. This is from 0 to pi. So this will be 2 a cube by 3. So pi plus 3 by 4. So it will be cos pi minus cos 0. So I can take minus 1 by 12 outside. So it will be cos 3 pi minus cos 0. So this will be 2 a cube by 3. So pi plus 3 by 4. So cos pi is minus 1. Cos 0 is 1. Minus 1 by 12. Cos 3 pi. So cos 3 pi is again minus 1. You know, cos n pi is minus 1 whole power n. So cos 3 pi will be minus 1 whole power 3. So cos 0 is again 1. So this will be 2 a cube by 3. So pi. So this will be minus 2, right? So if it will be minus 2. So this will be, if this 4, 2. So if this will be minus 2. So I can take cancel these 2. So we will have minus 3 by 2 plus 1 by 12, right? So we will have 3 by 4 into minus 2. 2 1s are 2 2s are. It's minus 3 by 2. So again, 2 a cube by 3. Pi, if I take LCM to these two terms, so it will be into 6 into 6. So we will have 2a cube by 9, right? Sorry, 2a cube by 9. 2a cube by 9, 3 pi minus 4, right? So if I do this, I'll have pi minus 18, right? 18 minus 17 by 12. I'm making some mistake, I think. Yes, here it is minus 1, right? Cos 0 is 1. So this will be minus 2. So it will be plus 1 by 6. Plus 1 by 6, sorry. You have to be very careful in doing the integration part. So we will have 2 a cube by 3. So we take LCM to these two terms. So into 3, into 3, into 1, into 1. So we will have minus 9 plus 1, which is minus 8 by 6. 5 minus 8 by 6. So if I cancel 8 and 6, so I will have 2a cube by 3, pi minus 3 by 2, right? Pi minus 3 by 2. So if I bring four by three. So two fours are, two threes are. So I can also write this as 2a cube by 3, 3 pi minus 4 by 3. So I can also write this as 2a cube by 9 into 3 pi minus 4. So that's it. So this is the answer. So 2a cube by 9 into 3 pi minus 4. So it's 2a cube, right? So that's it. So these are very important problems, that is from changing the Cartesian coordinate to cylindrical coordinate, right? So that's it. So we'll see you next video. Goodbye. Thank you.